Hello, I hope you're having a lovely Monday. Thank you for joining me for my brand new series. I'm going to be calling it Two Method Monday. And I thought for this series it would be fun to make two cards using supplies that are different, but using the same layout. The stamp set I'm choosing today is from Neat and Tangled, and it's called Just For You. It's the cutest little birthday stamp set. So we're going to jump in and start off with card number one and method number one. Now, the supplies that we're going to be using is the card base, of course. Two pieces of white cardstock, and this is a piece of a light blue pattern paper. And then I'm using my nesting circle dies, a cloud die, some black and white baker's twine, these are Ranger liquid pearls, and then I'm using six colors of ink, VersaFine, VersaMark, and then some clear embossing powder. Now that's everything we're going to be using to make this first card. Now I thought it would be fun to do a series that I know a lot of people don't have nesting dies, and I know a lot of people don't have different colors of inks or, you know, certain colors of embossing powders. So I wanted to make another card kind of using the same layout but with using different supplies, you know, because in case you don't have something, maybe you could improvise, and this will help you guys maybe choose something to improvise with. So here I am. I'm stamping, for this card I'm using some Hero Hues, and I'm stamping the present that was in the stamp set, and I'm using a pale tomato, a soft pool, and I actually messed up. I didn't wipe my stamp off for that second present there, so I stamped another soft pool, and then I'm also using orange soda. And then here I'm grabbing the balloon, the solid balloon in the stamp set, and I'm using green heels, real pretty green. And then I'm grabbing the passion flower, which is a really pretty purple. And then I'm also going to grab the butter bar, which is a real vibrant yellow, and I thought I'd stamp with that too. So we're going to be stamping three presents and three balloons. Now I'm going to go ahead and cut those out. I'm going to fussy cut them out. These are really easy. I didn't get the dies to this stamp set because the shapes in it were so basic that they would be easy to cut out. So here I cut them out, and now I want to work on my panel. So I'm grabbing two of my circle dies. These are the larger size, and I am going to be cutting out the larger circle with the white cardstock, and then the inside circle here I'm going to be using with the patterned paper. I'm going to go ahead and cut my clouds out and that circle with white cardstock, and then here I'm cutting out the pattern paper with the smaller circle. And any pattern paper that's a light blue would look really pretty with this card. Okay, now I'm going to stamp the sentiment. So for this, I'm choosing the happy birthday. The happy is on a banner, which I thought was really fun. So I'm just kind of positioning where I want to stamp it, and then I want that happy banner to be a different color. So I'm masking off the birthday, and then I'm taking that pale tomato, it's the same color as the present, and I'm going over that happy banner, and I'm going to stamp that on my pattern paper here. And then I'm going to do the opposite. I'm going to mask off that happy banner, and then I'm going to, using some VersaFine, I'm going to be stamping the birthday right below it there. Lovely. Now I did know that my red banner against that blue pattern paper, it kind of messed up the color a little bit. So I'm going to fix that. Here I took some VersaMark ink and I'm going over that whole stamp, and I stamped that whole image there. And then I'm coming in with some clear embossing powder, and I'm just going to heat set that. I thought if I heat set it would make that red stand out, but it still wasn't a very vibrant red. So I'm going to just grab a piece of white cardstock, some scratch paper here, and I'm going to stamp that happy banner. And I'm going to use that pale tomato again and just stamp it real fast and then go over it with some Versamark. And then I'm going to use clear embossing powder and I'm going to heat set that. And then I'm going to go ahead and cut that out just to save a little bit of time. And it ended up turning out really vibrant, like the present. And so now I'm taking my tape runner and I'm going to adhere this directly to my little white circle we cut out. Lovely. And then I am going to grab my card base and then I'm going to kind of find my placement. I'm going to flip it over and trim off the excess because I want it hanging off just a little bit. Lovely. And now I'm going to grab some foam tape and I'm just going to pop that up. I'm going to stick that directly on my card base. Lovely. I'm going to take that little banner and I'm going to pop that up as well and stick that right on top of the other one. And that color just worked out a lot better like that. Okay, now we're going to work on our presents and our balloons. I'm taking some baker's twine and I'm tying a knot on the bottom part of the balloon. And I'm going to go ahead and do that to all the balloons. I just tied one knot, I trimmed off one end, and then made the string a little bit longer. And I'm going to do that to all three balloons. Lovely. It turned out so cute. Love the way that looks. And then we're going to work on our present, and I'm just going to wrap that baker's twine around the white part of the present, and I'm going to do that to all four, I can't count today, boy. I'm going to do that to all three of those. Okay, now we've got our presents and our balloons. Let's see. Now we're going to grab our panel here, or actually our card base, and I'm just going to go ahead and arrange my balloons, and I'm going to pop them up with some foam tape, and then I arranged the clouds on here as well. And I think this just looks so adorable. Love this. And then I'm going to go in with the Ranger Liquid Pearls. And this is a real pretty orange color. And I'm just going to add some little accents to the card here. And this is a real pretty, like a lemon yellow color. And then here we're coming in with the green. And I think this turned out so adorable. Now, of the two cards that I made today, I think I prefer this one. But my kids and my husband prefer the other one. And I just, to flatten the liquid pearls a little bit, I just dropped it on my desk a couple times to help flatten it. Okay, now we're going to do the same layout, but we're going to do different methods. For this card, I'm using my card base, two pieces of white cardstock. I'm using, of course, the stamp set. I'm using some colored embossing powder, black embossing powder, some enamel dots, some VersaFine, and then I'm going to go through my, I went through my stash and found some pattern paper that had clouds on it. I know, and then here I'm using my alcohol markers for this card. Now, I want to make sure that they coordinated with those enamel dots. And then, before I actually invested in my nesting dies, I invested in this little circle cutter, and I love this thing. I haven't used it for years. And then I also have these circle punches. So I thought, you know what, if you guys don't have the circle dies and you have these products, it works really well. And actually, using my little circle cutter, this is from EK Success, but using this, I forgot how much I liked it. Believe it or not, I thought it was fun, you know, and that you have so many size options with this, but hadn't used it in a while, so I thought, this would be option number two if you don't have the nesting circle dies. Now here I cut this circle out of white cardstock, and it measures 3 3/4. And then I'm going to do the same thing to this pattern paper, and this measures 3 3/8. I know everybody has paper pads, and so cloud backgrounds are pretty popular. I actually found like 4 different colors. So this would be an option number 2 if you don't have a cloud die. So now in this particular stamp set, it has a present. It's like a negative present. And so actually this one's probably the positive. The first one I used was probably the negative. But I didn't want to use a black ink. So I decided I'm going to use some Versamark ink and stamp this present 3 times. And then I'm going to be using some white embossing powder. And I didn't show you that in the supplies earlier, but I did use the white embossing powder. And then this one also has a balloon outline, the stamp set. So I'm going to be using the balloon outline. And I stamped that 3 times with my Versamark as well. And I already added the white embossing powder, and now I'm just going to go over it and heat set it. And here you can see, I don't know if you can tell or not, but I thought it would be just fun and different using the white embossing powder. And now I sped my coloring up actually quite a bit, just because I wanted to get those colors in there. But I'm just going over with 2 tones of yellow, 2 tones of green, and 2 tones of this one's actually a lavender purple color. And then I'm making the presents blue, and then a real pretty pink, and then like a orangey reddish. Actually, the camera's kind of not doing it too much justice, because the pink and the orange, really, looking at it here, they kind of look really close in color. But and actually, you know, if you want to visit my blog at cardsandcoffeetime.com, I'll show close-up pictures, and you'll be able to see the color difference. Now I'm doing the exact same thing with my baker's twine, adding the strings to the balloons and wrapping those presents. And then I'm going to stamp my sentiment. Now I wasn't sure if my black embossing powder would show up, because this is pretty vivid blue, but it worked out really well. I was happy with it. So I'm just inking up my sentiment with Versamark ink. And I'm going to go over that whole stamp with black embossing powder. Now I got lucky. I forever and ever forget using my anti-static powder tool, but I did get lucky. It turned out pretty good, so. Okay, now that I have that done, I'm going to go ahead and grab my heat gun. I'm going to heat set my sentiment here. And at this point, you're probably thinking, why do I have a black banner that doesn't look very nice? But I'm going to fix that. I actually have some really pretty, it's like a corally reddish colored embossing powder. And so I'm going to cover that with that. I'm just grabbing some scratch paper, and using Versamark, I'm going to stamp that happy banner. And then I'm going to go ahead and use that colored embossing powder, and then I'm going to go ahead and cut that out. There we go. And then I'm going to just pop it up with some foam tape as well, and stick it right on top of that black one. See? Ta-da! Way better, huh? I'm going to stick both of them together. And then I'm going to place it and then trim off the excess here. And then I'm going to go ahead and add my balloons. First, I'm going to pop this up here. And then as far as the balloons went, I had just gathered the strings, all 3 of them, and then tied it in a knot. And then I secured that knot with a glue dot. And then I placed my presents on top of it. Almost as if the balloons were taking the presents away. And I thought that looked so cute. Now here, instead of using my liquid pearls, I'm using some enamel dots. Now, if you don't have enamel dots, you can use sequins, you can use jewels, I mean, nouveau drops, anything would work, you know, as far as a little accent to your card. And that's my second card. Thanks so much for joining me, guys. I hope you enjoyed my new series, my What I forgot what I called it. Oh my goodness, this is so bad. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this new series. Have a lovely day. And if you're new and like these cards, hit that subscribe button. And if you like this tutorial, you guys give me a thumbs up. Let me know how I'm doing in the comments below. And don't forget to check out my blog for close-up pictures. We'll see you next time. Have a great day. Bye-bye.